anybody else, then I will say good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you guys so much for having me. It's very, you're right, I need to update my bio. I am now a proud grandmother of two little ones. And so I'm not gonna hold you long because I know you guys are ready to eat. If you have not had an opportunity to come down on a Tuesday when we're here at the Villas, we come and fellowship with us. We bought over 1,000 washcloths, and that is just the beginning of our procedure to put the love bags together. We serve about 2,000 love bags a month. You First is, again, something that God gave me. August 7, 2014, woke up in a dream, wrote and started writing in the fall, and here we are in our fifth year. A few other places that Ms. Mary, like you said, needs to update. Delta Airlines has taken us global. It's about 3 weeks. And so we had an opportunity to do our ministry there. But before I sit down, I just wanted to kind of leave you with a few things that I, when I reflect on Thanksgiving, and just the journey of supporting those who are in need, and how I've been able to, I'll say, restructure my life. Because on your journey of life, you know, it's always constantly changing, especially when you move your life over to Christ. And so one of the things that I want to leave you with is five things to live by in gratitude. The first thing is a simple thank you. We all can do it. We all should do it. And it doesn't cost us anything. The second thing I would like to leave you with is love. Again, I just heard you say, no matter who we are in this journey, God loves us. And in love, it doesn't come with a package. It just is. It comes with leadership. It comes with giving. It comes with serving. And so continue to give love. Express through your thoughts. I'm honored to stand before you today because, one, my mom comes to QLS. She's a Red Hatter. And the stories that are told when I'm always around you guys remind me of my youth. Remind me that someone has paved the way for us Amen. To do what we're doing Amen. Right now. So when I stand before you, I am honored to be here in your presence because the stories that you guys have been able to tell for us will continue to leave a legacy. And the third thing I want to remind you guys is that no man is an island. Nothing that I've been able to accomplish with you First, I was able to do it by myself. Even coming here on a Tuesday and you guys preparing washcloths for us in fellowship, that is bringing unity together. And I know that I couldn't take this journey by myself, so I'm grateful for that. So on your life journey, just remember that no man is an island. I love the fact that you guys live here in camaraderie and you check on one another. And so continue to live in that and walk into that. The fourth thing is be the change that the world needs. Even in our latter years, you will be surprised at what your stories can do for those who are coming up. So don't be afraid to change the world. Don't be afraid to get out and do something different than you've ever been able to do before. I know you guys have a lot. You guys offer a lot of classes, dance classes, singing classes, whatever it is. And just that exposure to be able to talk about it with the youth, you just don't even know what they can do. And the last thing I'm going to leave you with is everyone is a gift. Each and every person that is in here today, you are a gift. You hold something so valuable, and I can't keep saying this enough. You are the gift that we need to continue the fight. Right now, we're living in a world where it's hatred, where people are speaking against one another, even with the same color of skin.
Exactly.
And so we have to stop fighting. We have to get back to love. Yeah. We have to remember that we are a special gift, and I'm grateful for each and every person that's in here. And I'm thankful, Ms. Mary, to allow me to stand before you guys today. And I won't hold you, but as you continue to navigate through your life journey, and on this reflection of Thanksgiving that's coming up, it's not even about the food that's nourishing to our souls, to our bodies, but it's about the journey. It's about having a conversation. It's about not forgetting those who have come before us. So I'm grateful. guys ready to eat.
I'm just gonna stand right here. She has given us some food.